I should never have gone to the theater. And I'd never have come to the country. If I never had come to the country, matters might have stayed as they were.
Sir?
Sir. If she'd only been faded, if she'd only been fat, if she'd only been jaded or bursting with chat, if she'd only been perfectly awful, it would have been wonderful. If she'd been on the Twitter or elusively cold or a little less bitter or better look passably old, if she'd been covered with glitter or even been covered with mold, it would have been wonderful. But the woman was perfection to my deepest dismay. Well, not quite perfection, I'm sorry to say. If the woman was perfection, she would go away, and that would be wonderful. Sir.
Sir? If she only looked flustered or admitted the worst, if she only had blustered or simpered or cursed, if she weren't so awfully perfect, it would have been wonderful. If she tried to be clever, if she'd started to flinch, if she cried or whatever a woman would do in a pinch, if I'd been certain she never again could be trusted an inch, it would have been wonderful. But the woman was perfection, not an action denied. The kind of perfection I cannot abide. If the woman were perfection, she'd have simply lied, which would have been wonderful.
If she'd only been vicious,
if she'd acted abused,
or a bit too delicious,
or been even slightly confused,
if she had only been sulky,
or bristling,
or bulky,
or bruised,
it would have been wonderful.
If
she only was willful,
if she only had fled,
or a little less skillful,
insulted, insisting,
in bed,
if she had only been fearful,
or married,
or tearful,
or dead,
it would have been wonderful. But the woman was perfection, and the prospects are grim. That lovely perfection that nothing can dim. Yes, the woman was perfection, so I'm here with him.
Sir?
Sir? It would have been wonderful.